Hi, in this video, we'll go over how to create a bill of materials for manufacturing. A bill of materials is a list of components and raw materials used to manufacture a product. You can also add operation types, instructions, and track your costs. Bill of materials can help when it's time to assemble the product using manufacturer orders. We'll take a look at that feature in depth in a future video. Let's get started. Open one of the products that your team manufactures. We encourage you to add all products and categories in inFlow to help with organization. Click on the Manufacturing tab. Click the Add a Bill of Materials button. This opens the product picker. You can scan or select all the component products that are used to manufacture this product. When you scan a barcode or select a component multiple times, it'll increase the quantity of the component added to the bill of materials. When done, click outside of the product picker to close it. At this point, we recommend saving the product record. If you want to make changes to a component's product details, put your cursor over the product and select the blue icon. This opens the component product record in a new tab where you can make changes. You can use the quantity field to make adjustments to the number of components used. And if you've added a component by mistake, you can hover over the product and select the X to the right of that row. If your company manufactures many products, you can add a bill of materials to multiple products at once with a CSV import. Take a look at the links in the description to learn more. This sums up the basics of how to create a bill of materials. If that's all you wanted to know, be sure to check out the links in the description to learn more about inFlow's manufacturer orders. Stick around if you'd like to learn about manufacturing operations and cost tracking. Next to the bill of materials, you might have noticed the operations section. Operations, also known as manufacturing routing, is where you can track a list of steps needed to manufacture the product. At the top of the operation is the assembly operation type. Operation types are a general description of the manufacturing stages. To add another operation type, you can start typing into the field, then click the plus icon that loads below. Select Manage Operation Types from the drop-down menu if you want to rename or add new operation types to inFlow. Under the operation type is Add Costs. This is where you can enter an estimate for how much the operation will cost to manufacture. Labor cost is where you can track hourly labor. Estimated duration is where you can enter how long this operation will take. This field is connected to the labor cost to give an estimate. Per unit cost is where you can track fees or flat rates for this operation. For example, if your team outsources part of the manufacturing to a third party. For more details on how costing works, check out the Bill of Materials article in the Learning Center. Next is Add Instructions. This is where you can add written guides for this operation. You can add the steps in this text field or add a link if the steps already exist online. Links added to the instruction field are clickable, and they'll open in a new browser tab. Once that's done, repeat these steps to add other operations to the bill of materials. By the way, operations can be imported to inFlow. Check out the guides in the description to learn more. That covers how to create a bill of materials. If you have any questions, feel free to get in touch with the inFlow team. You can find contact details on screen or linked in the description. Thanks for watching.